The first method in determining deflection or slope, called double integration, method. We have a beam, probably fixed. This beam, I will figure out what are the reactions first. Then I will assume a distance X and I will do my cut. And I will use the left part to draw my free body diagram for the cut. So your cut looks like this. We have reaction. We have load, probably. So at this cut, we have three things. Normal, we don't care. Shear, I don't care. And we have moment, would like to make this member to smile. I need to figure out an equation of this moment as a function of distance X. In your homework, you have a problem, looks like this one. For example, we have a triangle. Okay, I don't care, triangle or uniform or any shape, I don't care. My solution steps are the same. First of all, what are the reactions? So I need to figure out these reactions. I think the horizontal reaction here will be zero. The vertical reaction at A will be something like 13.33, and the reaction at this support B will be 26.67. First step, I need to assume distance X. Okay, go ahead from your left. From your left, I will assume a distance X. At this location, I will do my cut. And I will use the left part of your cut. So what do you have in your left? What do you have on your left? Here is a free body diagram. We have reaction here, 13.33. We have horizontal reaction here, zero. And we have a little bit of the triangle. And remember, this distance is X. At your cut, we have normal. I don't care. We have shear. I don't care. We have moment, M. We need to figure out what is the value of M. So we have to take moment at this cut to figure out what is the value of M. Anybody can tell me what is the value of this distributed load of this triangle? What is the value here? What is the value of this point? Remember, you did cut here. So I'm looking for this value. I'm looking for this one. What is the value at for this little triangle? Nobody, don't tell me 8, because 8 is the value at the end of the triangle. But if you are looking for what is the value here, you need to do some triangle similarity between this triangle and this triangle. So I can say, if you assume this one is W, so I can say W divide 8, W divide 8 equal X divide 10. So W will be 8X divide 10. This is the value here. Any question for this point? Any question for this point? Okay. Any question for this point? So for triangle, your value here will be done using triangle similarity. For uniform distributed load, we don't need to do this, because if you assume distance X and we make your cut, your value here will be the same like here, it's 8. It's different. But if you have triangle, looks different a little bit. Okay. So right now you can solve for problem 1 and the problem 2 in homework number 7. We will try to cover the rest of the problems 3 and 4 today and the next slide. Let's go back to our topic today. Conjugate beam will do the same. Will calculate deflection Y and will calculate theta, which called rotation or slope. We'll do the same like double integration method, but double integration method solving very, very simple problem. If you watch this problem, this one is very simple. Just a beam with one fixed from one end. Just a beam with two support, hinge and roller. Just a beam with two support, hinge and roller. Very, very simple beam. But if your beam is more complicated, like beam with cantilever, or we have pin connection, and we have many supports fixed and roller and, that means we need more complicated problem, more complicated method can help us to solve for deflection and theta. Conjugate beam can do this. Conjugate beam method. First step in your beam in this method, you have to solve to draw bending moment diagram. But your bending moment diagram in this method will be more easy. Will be more easy. Just you need to learn what's going on, because these shapes will be given in your exam. The first one, if you have simple beam, if I'm talking about simple beam, I mean beam between hinge and roller. This is called simple beam. If you have simple beam with one concentrated load, your moment looks like triangle. The vertex of this triangle will be at the location of this concentrated load. That means if your concentrated load at this location, your triangle vertex will be here. If your concentrated load at mid-span, the vertex of the triangle will be at mid-span. So the vertex of the triangle will be at the same location of the concentrated load. The value of this moment will be P, the concentrated load value, time distance A, time distance B, divide the total length L. L is the total distance for the beam, L. If you have a beam with uniform distributed load, your moment will be looks like parabola, second order, we don't care. It's a parabola. The maximum moment of this parabola, W, the uniform load value, L squared divide 8. L is the total span for this beam, WL squared over 8. If you have simply supported beam with only one concentrated moment at the end, that means we have a value at the location of this moment equal M, and at the other support, we don't have anything, just zero, and I will connect between the two values by a line. Be careful for this case, because your moment looks like this, or your moment looks like this, your value must follow the head of the arrow. We have a head here. This head will make this value down, because the value will be at the same location of the head. Zero at the other side, so your shape looks like triangle in negative side. But here, the head of the arrow is up, so your value will be up, M, and here we have zero, so your triangle will be positive shape. So be careful, you have to figure out, how can I figure out the direction of my moment, clockwise or counterclockwise? No, we don't care. Clockwise or counterclockwise. Our concern is, where is the position of the head? One student will ask me a good question, and I respect this. If I have a moment looks like this, or if I have a moment looks like this, no way. Hey, please, your moment must be outside the beam. Your moment must be outside the beam. What you mean by outside? This moment will be rotated to be like this. I didn't change anything. Your moment is still counterclockwise. But I asked the moment, hey, can you rotate a little bit to be outside the beam? Once the moment is outside the beam, I can figure out that this head is down. So your value here will be down. And here is zero, so I can draw a triangle that looks like this. If your moment is outside the beam and the head and the arrow, both of them are down, no, your moment will be adjusted to be like this. I didn't change the direction, but I have to put the head and the tail of the arrow to figure out which one is up and which one is down. I didn't change the direction. Your moment is still rotating clockwise, but only I adjusted it to figure out where is the head and where is the tail. So your head will be down and the other side will be zero, so I can connect a line. Then, this is the first cases if you have simply supported beam. All of these cases will be given in your exam. You don't need to remember, but you need to learn how to use them in your solution. If you have cantilever, if you are talking about cantilever, I mean beam supported from one side on a fixed support. This is called cantilever. If you have concentrated load at the end of this cantilever, your moment looks like triangle. Your value here will be P times L. P is the concentrated load value. L is the total length. If you have uniform distributed load, your moment here will be W L square divided 2. W is the uniform load value. L is the length of the cantilever. Square divided 2, and your moment looks like parabola like this. If you have concentrated moment, your value here will be down following the arrow, the head of the arrow, and this value will be constant through the whole length of the cantilever. That means, hey guys, that means if you have cantilever looks like this and your concentrated moment like this, okay, your moment must follow the head of the arrow. So your moment will be up, and then this value will be constant through the cantilever. So your values will be positive, but in this case, your values is negative. This one is negative, this one is negative. Anyway, any questions so far? Any questions so far? No, these graphs and these values will be given in your exam. Will be given in your exam. So at least you need to be familiar with these diagrams. You need to be familiar what's going on. Okay? Okay, if you have simply supported beam attached to a cantilever. So I think this shape with concentrated load looks like this shape. Exactly. Okay. So on this shape, we have this triangle, like this one. And this value will be P times L. Then at the end of the simply supported beam is zero, so I will connect to zero. These cases will be given, these cases will be given, but these cases will not be given because these cases depend on the previous case. If you have concentrated moment at the end of the cantilever, and this cantilever is attached to simply supported beam, okay, this part looks like exactly like this one. So on this part, we have M following the head of the arrow and the constant to the end of this cantilever only. And on the other side of the simply supported beam, it's zero. So I have to connect it to zero. If you have cantilever attached to simply supported beam and this cantilever with uniform distributed load, this cantilever looks like this one exactly. So on this bar, we have a value here, WL squared divided 2, and your moment is a parabola. Looks like this. Looks like this one exactly. At the end, on the other side of the simply supported beam, it's zero, so I have to connect by straight line to zero. So it's very easy. So these cases will not be given because these cases, you can figure out them using the previous cases. So I'm clear in this point. Simply supported cases, simply supported beam cases will be given, or cantilever beam cases will be given. Any other cases? No, you need to figure them out. Okay, I agree with you. These cases, we don't have anything on the simply supported beam. So I connect it to zero. I connect it to zero. I connect it to zero. What will happen if you have a cantilever attached to simply supported beam? And on the cantilever, we have concentrated load. And on the simply supported beam, we have uniform distributed load. What will happen? So we have two cases right now. This case, I think, and this case. Simply supported beam with uniform distributed, and the cantilever with concentrated load. In this case. So, we will use something or a method called superposition. Superposition means I will assume, just assume, that this beam with concentrated load only plus this beam with uniform distributed load only. I do separation. Each load alone on the beam. So this beam can be converted to two cases. And the two cases are added together. The first case, I'm going to assume this beam with uniform distributed loop only. Plus, I will assume this beam with one concentrated loop P only. And this one, plus this one, you can get the final effect if you have both of them at the same time. Why you are doing this? To make your problem more simple. Because if you have only one concentrated load on the cantilever, I believe your moment will be P times L1. I can get the moment here. On the other side, it's zero, so I will connect it to zero. If you have uniform distributed load alone on simply supported beam, your moment looks like parabola. And your value here will be WL squared divided 8. Because you have both of them, that means we have both of these two diagrams, this triangle and this parabola at the same time. So if you would like, if you would like to draw the final bending moment, your final moment will be like this. But this method can be called superposition method. Why superposition? Because you assumed every load is alone. We have this triangle with value here PL1. L1 is the distance here. And we have another shape, looks like parabola. And your value here will be W, L2 square divide 8. L2 is the length of this simply supported beam. This bending moment diagram is a technique, a new technique to draw bending moment diagram in a method called superposition method. Any questions so far? We covered this last time, but any questions so far? Any question so far? It's very simple. Just assume each load is alone. Once you did, you can see that your beam looks like one of these six cases. This one, or 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 this one. It will be very, very, very simple. Second step in this method. You need to convert the real beam, which is given in your exam or quiz or homework, the beam which is given, to a new beam. This new beam can be called conjugate beam. So please convert the real beam which is given, the real beam which is given in your homework, in your exam, quiz, whatever, to a new beam which called conjugate beam. Okay, tell me, how can I convert the real beam to a conjugate beam? We need to use these rules. Also, this table will be given in your exam. You don't need to remember, but you need to learn how to use this table. It's very easy. If you have in the real beam hinge, support, leave it, keep it, hinge support. If you have roller support, leave it, roller support. If you have fixed support, no, make it free. Remove the fixed support. If you have free, make it fixed. If you have hinge or roller, intermediate hinge or roller, internal hinge or roller, make them hinge connection or pin connection. If you have hinge or pin connection in the real beam, go ahead and convert it to be a roller. I'm sorry, I got confused. Okay, let's try for this example. This one is the real beam. It's given in your exam, real beam, or homework, or quiz. Can you tell me, how can I convert it to be conjugate beam? Okay, we need to follow the rules. What type of support here do you have? What is the type? What is the type of support at this point? It's a hinge or pin support. Okay, I know it's a hinge or pin. Is it intermediate or at the edge of the beam? I think it's at the edge. If you have hinge support at the edge, leave it as it is. So we still have hinge here. What type of support here? It's roller. Yeah, I know it's roller. But is it intermediate roller or at the edge of the beam? I think this support not at the edge. It's internal support. Internal support. So if you have roller, internal roller of the beam, please go ahead and convert it to be pin connection. So at this location, we have pin connection. What else? What about this point? The end of the beam. Do you have any support? No, I don't have any support. So it can be called free. If you have free point, please go ahead and convert it to be fixed. We have fixed here. Wow. That means I converted my real beam, which is given, to a new beam with fixed pin connection and the hinge. The new beam can be called conjugate beam. One more time. Okay. This beam we have here fixed at A. We have at B pin connection. We have at C, at D, its roller at the end. This beam is the real beam which is given. Can you tell me how can I convert this real beam to a new beam which is called conjugate beam? Yeah, it's very easy. Step by step. Let's try with the first one. What type of support do you have at A? It's fixed, okay? If you have fixed support in the real beam, go ahead and make it free. That means we don't have anything here. If you have pin connection, go ahead and make this pin connection to be a roller. So we have roller here. If you have roller at the edge of the beam, leave it to be a roller also. That means we have roller here. So the new beam will be called conjugate beam. It's very easy. This table will be given. You need only to understand, to learn how to use it. So I think the first step, how to draw bending moment, and this diagram will be given. The second step, how to convert your real beam to a conjugate beam, and this table will be given. I think these two steps will be more easy, very easy. What do you think? Anybody has any question? Yes, your new beam will be free, roller. So first step, go ahead and draw bending moment diagram with superposition method. Second step, convert your real beam to a new beam using this table, and this table will be given in your exam. We still have two more steps. Step number three, convert the bending moment diagram to elastic load by calculating the area of the moment diagram and calculate the elastic reaction. I believe if you did until this step, you can gain from 80 to 90% of the score of this problem. Convert bending moment diagram to elastic load by calculating the area of moment diagram and calculate the elastic reaction. It's not clear for me. And then calculate the deflection and the rotation by this theorem and this one. Okay, I will go through an solved example, and we will see what you mean by this step. It's very easy, don't worry. But before starting, I would like to remind you for something. If you have a parabola, and this value is M, for example, and this length is L, anybody can tell me what is the area of this parabola? If you have triangle, looks like this, and your value here is M, and this length is L, anybody can tell me what is the area of this triangle? Everybody, can you tell me what is the area of a parabola? Anybody know? Why is the internal pin is a roller? Because the table did this. If you have internal pin connection, please go ahead and convert it to be a roller. These rules, it's not from mine. These rules based on the method, conjugate beam method. Hey, Alex, pin connection must be converted to be roller. If you have roller, convert it to pin connection. WL squared divide 8. No, I'm not asking for what is the value of bending moment. This value is WL squared over 8. Yes. No, I'm asking for what is the area. I'm talking about area of a shape. This shape, what is the area? WL squared over 8, only this height. Two-thirds WL. You are correct, Brock, but not correct. You are wrong and correct at the same time, both of them. I'm not sure how. This parabola with a value M here, I will assume that we have a rectangle like this. Anybody can tell me what is the area of this rectangle? What is the area of this rectangle? I think this height is M. This length is L. So the area of the rectangle will be ML. Perfect. ML. If you multiply this area of the rectangle by two-thirds, you are talking about the area of the parabola. Because area of a parabola equal two-thirds area of rectangle which containing or including the parabola. Keep it in your mind. Area of a triangle, it's a piece of cake, 1/2 time L time L. 1/2 time base time height, I can figure out what is the area of a triangle. If you have different shape of triangles, like this one, for example, okay, you can divide it to two triangles. This triangle with area, 1/2 time base time height, and another triangle. I forget something very important. You have to remember. I think most of you know this. Where is the centroid of the triangle? I think this centroid will be at 1/3 of the L, and the other distance will be 2/3. The centroid of a parabola at the midspan. This centroid at distance L divided 2 and distance L divided 2. Keep them in your mind for triangle or for parabola. The area of a parabola, 2/3, the area of rectangle. And the centroid at midspan for triangle, 1/2 time L time M, and the centroid at 1/3 or 2/3 based on. You said 2/3 W. L. What you mean by W? W is the value of the uniform root. Yeah, okay. So I said you are correct and wrong at the same time. Thank you, Brock. Thank you. Okay, okay. Thank you, man. Let's start this example. Because we still have only 15 minutes, so I will cover this example. And I will continue next time. For this problem, we have fixed support at A. We have pin connection at B. we have a roller at D. And we have one concentrated load, 25 kilonewton. And we need to determine what is the rotation, theta, at A and D. What is the deflection or displacement at P and C, which is Y. A is fixed, B is a pin connection, and D is a roller, EI is a constant, using conjugate beam method. Anybody remember what was the first step? First step, we need to draw bending moment diagram. Before drawing bending moment diagram, if you go back to chapter 2, and I need to figure out what are the reactions for this beam. If you go back to chapter 2 and you have beam connection, I will do separation. This part alone with fixed, and this part alone with roller. At roller, we have one reaction. At fixed, we have three reactions. What will happen here? We will have vertical load and horizontal. These loads will be the same, but in opposite direction on the other side. And we have one concentrated load, 25 kilonewton. If you try to get your reactions, I think I will start with the right part. This one will be 12.5 kilonewton. This one will be 12.5 kilonewton. This horizontal reaction will be zero. These two reactions will be the same values, but in opposite direction on the other side, zero and 12.5. If you go ahead and apply a Grobian equation for the second part, this reaction will be 12.5. And this horizontal reaction will be zero. And this concentrated moment will be 37.5. Just very simple problem. Go ahead and apply summation f of x equals zero, summation f of y equals zero, summation moment at any point equals zero. I can figure out what are the reactions. These two reactions will be the same here, but in opposite direction. Go ahead and apply summation f of x equals zero, summation f of y equals zero, summation moment at any point equals zero. I can figure out the reactions as support. Any questions so far? Chapter 2. Any questions so far? Any questions so far? Very simple. Okay. First step, we need to draw bending moment diagram using method of superposition. You need to be more smart in this step. Here is the beam. We have fixed here. We have pink connection at this location. We have roller. Go ahead. I think this part of the beam with one concentrated load, 25, and this reaction, and this reaction, and this reaction, I think this part looks like this. What do you think? Do you agree? Yeah. What is the meaning of hinge? What do you mean by hinge? I mean, we have vertical reaction, horizontal reaction. What do you mean by roller? We have vertical reaction. Wow. And we have concentrated load. Okay. I think we are in the same situation. We have two reactions. That means we have hinge. Or something looks like hinge. We have one reaction. That means we have roller. So we have simply supported beam with one concentrated load. Anybody remember what was the bending moment diagram? Yeah, it will look like triangle. And the vertex of this triangle will be at the same location of the concentrated load. The value of this moment will be 25 times 3 times 3 divided 6. Wow. Are you serious? Yes. We have distance A equal 3. We have distance B equal 3. And the total length is 6, which is L. And I told you, if you have simply supported beam, which will be given in the exam, don't worry, your bending moment diagram will be triangle. And this value will be P A B divided L. P 25, A 3, B 3. Divide L, 6. Do you agree? Do you agree? Okay. So I am done with the first part of the beam. We have only triangle. Can you remind me what is the shape of the second part of the beam? Yeah, I think this part looks like this. We have a beam fixed from one side, and we have concentrated load at this location. Yeah, exactly. 12.5. Do you remember this shape? Yeah, go back to these shapes, which will be given in the exam. I think if you have a cantilever with fixed from one side with one concentrated load, your bending moment diagram looks like triangle. And this value, PL. So I think your bending moment diagram here will be something looks like this. And this value will be 12.5 times 3. I'm sorry, what you mean by 12.5 times 3? Yes, I mean we have a cantilever, fix it, and your value P, and this value is L. Your P equal 12.5, your span L equal 3 meter. That means your bending moment at this location, which is triangle, P times L. P 12.5 times L 3, your final answer will be 12.5 times 3, 37.5. So I think we have a triangle here, 37.5. I am done with the first step. Draw bending moment diagram using superposition method. If you have beam connection, please go ahead and do separation first. Because if you did separation, you are converting your beam to more simply beam, simple part. So once you did your separation, I figured out that this part looks like simply supported beam with concentrated load. I figured out this part of the beam looks like cantilever with one concentrated load. So I can draw bending moment diagram for this part and the bending moment diagram for the other part. This is the first step. Any question so far? Any question so far? You have any question, let me know. Second step. You remember what was the second step? Yes, second step. Convert the real beam to conjugate beam. So you have to keep this table on front of you. This table will be given also in the exam. So let's start our new beam. Will be looks like let's start. You have fixed support. You have fixed support at A. What will happen if you have fixed? Go back to this table. If you have fixed support in the real beam, please go ahead and make it free. So we don't have anything at A. Nothing here. Second point, B. It's pin connection. If you have pin connection, what should I do? Go back to your table. If you have pin connection, please go ahead and make it roller support. So at point B, I will make it roller support. Then point D, the next point, it's roller at the end, edge roller or roller at the end of the beam. Go back to the table. If you have roller at the end of the beam, please keep it as it is. So at point D, we will have a roller. We'll keep it as it is because it's a roller already. That means this new beam called conjugate beam. It's very easy. Can you redraw this bending moment diagram on the new beam? Yes. Your bending moment diagram on the new beam will be like this. I think this value, we didn't get this value. This value is 25 times 3 divide 6. It was 37.5. So this value 37.5 and this one 37.5. This one is negative, this one is positive. Any question? It's very easy. Just take this moment as it is and put it on the new beam, which called the conjugate beam. The next step is very easy. Just math calculation. We have here roller. We have here roller. We have here. Everybody, please pay attention. We have here load, and we have here load. Hey, wait. I have question. Why you draw this load up, and why you draw this load down? For one reason. Because the bending moment diagram here is positive. That means your load going up. Your bending moment diagram here is negative, so your load is going down. One more time. Your bending moment diagram that you did in the first step is positive. That means your load going up. Your bending moment diagram is negative, so your load going down. This is the first one. Second one, where can I put this load and this load? At the centroid of this triangle. Do you know what is the centroid of this triangle? Yes, at midspan. Where can I put this load? At the centroid of this rectangle. The centroid of this rectangle at 1/3 and 2/3. So location of these loads at centroid of the shape of your bending moment diagram. If you have a parabola at midspan, if you have right angle triangle at 1/3, 2/3. If you have equilateral triangle like this at midspan. One more thing, can you tell me what is the value of these loops? Yeah, I can tell you what is the area of this triangle. Can you tell me what is the area of this triangle? Yeah, 1/2 times 6 times 37.5. This area, 1/2 times 6, 6 is the total distance. Time 37.5, your load value 112.5. Can you tell me what is the value of this load? Yes, the area of this triangle. 1/2 times 3 times 37.5, your value will be 56.25. So I have concentrated load here, 112.5, and I have concentrated load here, 56.25. This distance will be 3 meters. This distance will be 3 meters. This distance will be 2 meters. This distance will be 1 meter, 1/3 and 2/3. Hey guys, this is a step that said convert bending moment diagram to be load. How? By calculating the area of the moment diagram. So this step is very, very, very simple. Very simple. We have 3 things you need to remember. Your load will be up or down based on the sign of the diagram. If your bending moment positive, will go up, the force will go up. If your bending moment is negative, the force will go down. Where can I put these loads? At the centroid of this diagram. How much? These loads, the area of this diagram. Any question so far? It's very easy. Hey guys, are you still here? Okay. Finally, we have a new beam and we have a new load. Can you tell me the new reaction? Yeah, I'm serious. We have a new beam, which called conjugate beam. We have a new load that you get it from the bending moment. So that means we have new reaction, R1 and R2. Go ahead and apply summation F of Y equals zero, summation moment at any point equals zero to figure out what is the value of reaction R1, what is the value of reaction R2. So to be more specific, this load called elastic load. This load called elastic load. So because your load is elastic, your reaction will be elastic reaction. Actually, I don't care with the word elastic. It's a load and a reaction. But we can call it elastic load because we have a big difference between this load, which is 25 kilonewton, it's actual load. But this load, it's not a real load. It's coming from this bending moment diagram, so we can call it elastic load. If you have elastic load, that means we have elastic reaction. We need to figure them out. So this step, which called convert bending moment diagram to elastic load, by calculating the area of moment diagram. Once you have elastic load, go ahead and calculate the elastic reaction. I believe if you did until this point, for me, I will give you around 90% of the total score of this problem. Because we didn't, until this moment, we didn't figure out what is the value of theta at A, what is the value of theta at D, what is the value of displacement at B and C. It's a piece of cake, just very, very simple calculations. So it's very easy. We will continue next time. But to remind you, we have some steps. First step, you need to draw bending moment diagram. To do this, you have to make separation at bin connection to figure out the reaction in between. Once you did, you can figure out that we have simply supported beam with concentrated goods. Your moment looks like triangle. We have a cantilever with less concentrated goods. We have another triangle. Second step, convert your real beam to a conjugate beam with a table. So I converted it to a new beam. Go ahead and put the bending moment diagram, identical shape, on the new beam. Convert this bending moment diagram to elastic load. How? Direction up or down based on the sign, positive or negative. Location based on where is the centroid of these shapes. Values, what is the area of this shape? Once you convert your bending moment diagram to elastic load, that means we have elastic reaction. So we have a new beam, we have a new load. That means we have a new reaction. These reactions and these loads can be called elastic load and elastic reaction.